forward to the summer musical. Well, things will be a little bit different this year. Kate Reibel is here. She's the executive director of the Public Education Foundation. Good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here, because I think we need to tell everybody exactly how this is going to go. First of all, Kate, what is the summer musical?
So the summer musical this year, the kids have been working on music from Sweeney Todd, the Demon Barber of Fleet Street. So some of you might be familiar with the movie that was released not too long ago.
Well, give us a little bit of the story, if you will.
Sure. So there is an English barber that is Sweeney Todd, and he has had some injustice in his life, and he's a little bit out for revenge. There's a little bit of a story of romance and love in there, and just a lot of really fun and challenging songs along the way.
Yeah, some great music came out of that show for sure. All right, so now in these days of COVID-19 and social distancing, et cetera, how can we actually see the summer musical?
So this year is going to be the first time in 32 summers that the students cannot get up on the stage and perform this. And we are just as disappointed as everybody else. But when we had to make these decisions back in March and April, when we were meeting as a group, you know, our first priority just had to be student safety and concern for everybody's well-being. And then our second priority was making sure a fine arts experience could continue. So just because you can't see the students does not mean they are not working hard on material and singing together and collaborating behind the scenes.
So will there be a virtual performance of sorts so that folks can see and support the experience?
We are trying our hardest to at least have a little bit to release. We do want to be careful, of course, with legalities of having the rights to a show, since we're not actually performing on stage. But if we have something that we can release to the public, we absolutely will. What we're putting together now is really more of a keepsake for the students so that they can remember their time working on the summer musical virtually. Hopefully the last time they'll have to do that.
I hope so, too. Now, had the kids already begun to rehearse when all the closings happened?
Absolutely. So we held our virtual auditions in April and went ahead and cast the show, knowing that we couldn't go on stage, but hoping that we would figure it out along the way. And we did. We have a wonderful production team. The cast has been meeting in a virtual classroom to work on scenes and work on their songs. The orchestra has set up a digital recording studio at AIS Diamond at the Fine Arts Department. And so they are working in a safe and individual environment to record their piece. And then we also have developed some really fun virtual classroom experiences for the crew this year as well. So they're working on building scale models. We delivered little boxes of goodies to them that they would need to make scale models, and they have been getting a real education of technical theater in their virtual classroom. So something very different than their normal experience.
Well, we've all had to innovate, and it sounds like the Public Education Foundation figured it out.
That's right. I hope so.
Thank you, Kate, for being with us this morning.
Thanks so much, Angie.
My pleasure. We'll be back with more Local Lifestyles right after this. Stay with us.